Hi, my name is Noah Gift, and today I'm going to talk to you about how to set up a Hello World continuous integration with GitHub Actions on all major cloud environments. We should be able to tackle this in just a few minutes. Let's go and get started. Let's take a look at a common scenario here that I see a lot with students, with professionals, is that they need to build something and test it out. And how do they get started? Well, I think GitHub is probably the cleanest solution for most people. And the reason for that is it has something called Actions. What is Actions? It's a build system that will test your code automatically. In fact, it can do any task, including building containers or deploying code. But in this situation, if we want to do continuous integration, we can do this with the Cloudshell environment. We can do it with Google Cloudshell, Azure Cloudshell, GitHub Codespaces, all environments. You can do the same process of checking out your code, testing it, linting it, formatting it. And what it does is it actually saves you time throughout the life of your project. It doesn't cost you time, it saves you time. And the process is very similar for all these environments. Let's go ahead and build this out ourselves. Okay, let's dive in and build out a Hello World GitHub Actions. I'm going to refer to this GitHub Actions PyTest as a template, but I'm going to start a new repo. So let's go ahead and start a new repo from scratch here, and we'll call this GitHub Actions Hello World. And what I would recommend is put a description when you first set up things. So we'll say Hello World, add a readme file, add a git ignore. This is critical to being able to work efficiently for Python. You would want to do the Python git ignore file so it doesn't check in garbage, and then we're ready to go. So really the first thing I'm going to do here is just put in a image. So I'm going to say new issue, and just put a screenshot in here that shows a little bit of what I'm doing. And I'll go through here, throw this in, and there we go. I like to do this just to give myself an overview of what I'm actually going to build out. So this is what we're going to do. We're going to build this thing out, which is a Hello World for all three of these environments: AWS Cloudshell, Google Cloudshell, Azure Cloudshell, and GitHub Codespaces. So I'm going to start with the easy one, which is GitHub Codespaces. And there's no particular order that we need to go. I'm going to click on code and then say new code space. Now, if you don't have access to this, it's fine. We're also gonna set this up for other cloud shells. I think this is a great environment though to do Hello World type testing. The very first thing that I would recommend when you're building out a environment is to make sure that you've got a virtual environment set up. That's really step one. And this would be for all environments, is make sure that you can actually build that out. So step one here, I'm gonna say virtual env, tilde.venv. So this creates a virtual environment in my home directory that's hidden. There we go. Next step, I will go ahead and source this thing. We could get fancy as well if we wanted to and actually put this into our bash rc file. And why don't we just do that? Because that's a great idea. This is a little trick. If you do a hash mark there, it'll save that thing for later. I'm going to use vim and I'm going to do tilde slash dot bash RC, here we go. And I'll do a shift G to get to the bottom, O to open up a new line, and then we'll say source virtual env. I'll go ahead and paste that in. And now what'll happen is every time I open a new shell, look, we've got that virtual environment source. So it's a great way to work, is using these virtual environments, because they eliminate a lot of problems with dependencies. So I'm gonna go ahead and now create the scaffolding for a project. And this will be a makefile, which is what I like to use. We'll create a hello.py file. We'll create a test hello.py file. And then we'll create a requirements file. And so this is really all you need to do when you're creating a scaffolding. And again, it seems like a little bit of work, but it saves you time in the long run. So how would we populate this makefile? Well, I like to be lazy. I'm going to grab one that I've created before. So again, once you've created one of these, you can just copy from your project and build it out in the future. So I'm gonna go through here and build this out. And notice it's got a pip install command, and this allows us to really cleanly use one small command to install. And then later when we get to the build system, this will also make it very simple. Here we go, test, right? I go through here and I have a test process. This is nice because it allows us to format our code. Linting allows me to really have confidence that I don't have small syntax errors in my code. And now we can go through and add the requirements as well. So I'm going to refer back to this project that I can just use this as a template. And this is really a pattern that you'll see is once you get used to this, you can actually build these things out very quickly in the future. Okay, we've got that. And so I can just say make install, and this will go through and it'll look inside that requirements file, install my code. Next up, now that I've got that running, I'm gonna go to hello. I'm gonna build an add function. This is one of my things I like to build. So we'll go ahead and we'll say add, and we'll say X and Y, and then we'll just return back X plus Y. And then we can just print down here the result, and we'll say, you know, add one and one. And what will that do? If I just say Python hello, right, we can say it returns two. So great, that looks like it works. Now we can actually build out a test. Pretty simple. I just say from hello, import add. And then to build out a test in Python, you would just say test, the name of the function. And then we would go assert that two is equal to add one and one, right? So pretty logical. And with PyTest, it's very trivial to add unit test for your project. And now if I type in make all, everything runs, right? I have an installation step, I have a lint step, and I have a test step. So this is really the hello world to get your project working. I can say get add star because of the get ignore. If I say get status, you can see here I've got these four files. We'll go ahead and commit this, adding scaffold. There we go. And we can go ahead and say get push. Perfect, we're all good to go. And now notice that if I want to, I can go back to this repo, refresh, it's all filled out, and we're ready to go to add continuous integration. How do I do this? I click on actions. I would say set up workflow yourself, although this is a great idea to look through some of these other projects that you could set up, but I'm gonna go ahead and say set up. Again, I'll go to my other project here where I've got some examples set up. I'm gonna go ahead and say raw, just copy it, paste it into this other project here. We'll go ahead and paste this. And so this is a very easy process to test our code because I just do the same things I did locally. I say make install, make lint, make test, make format. Very, very simple and repeatable process because we have the make file. Let's go ahead and start this. It'll immediately start the build. We click on actions. We go through here. And in a second here, we should see the actions build out. There we go. And you'll notice if you click on it, you can see it in real time. It'll go through here and it'll run all those steps that we told. You can add extra steps if you want. You want to maybe build a container or deploy your code to a cloud environment. That's fine. You'll go through here and all these will successfully run. So really we're done. It just took us a few minutes to set this up. We can even be fancy here. We can create a status badge, copy it, and then go back to our environment and paste this into our README file. So what's next? Well, let's go ahead and set up another environment in another cloud environment. So just because you do or do not have access to GitHub Actions doesn't mean, again, we can see that this actually passed here, right, because it's green. It doesn't mean you can't do things in another environment. So how do we do this? Well, pretty simple. The first thing I need is I need to go to code, local, and make sure that I can access this URL. So I'm gonna go ahead and copy this. Now I'm gonna go to AWS. In AWS, I just click on AWS Cloudshell. You could also use Cloud9 as well. I'm gonna do it from the shell to make things simple. So I'm gonna spin this up, let this thing run. I'm also gonna go to Google Cloud. We can say activate Cloudshell, same thing, we'll spin this up. I'm also gonna go to Azure. I'm gonna go through here. We've already got this thing running. So let's start with Azure since it's already running. So again, the first step we do is we just say Python 3-m venv. There's two ways to create virtual environments. One is with the built-in Python module. The other one is the virtual environment tool. I'm gonna go ahead and use this one because this is what's valid for this cloud platform. They both work the same. And then we can do venv bin activate. Now, again, you could put this in your bash shell, but let's just be simple here and not do that. It's gonna say get clone. We don't have SSH keys. So that's the only step that really is different is you have to set up SSH keys. How do you do this? Well, you just type in SSH hyphen keygen dash T RSA. It's gonna be the same thing on every cloud platform. You do this, you then print out the keys, here we go, like that. Take this key and you just put it into your GitHub account. And so I'm gonna go back to my GitHub account here, and I'm gonna go to my profile and just paste this in. Go to settings, go to SSH GPG keys, create a new key, go here. We'll call this Azure 2022. Save it, it'll ask for authentication. We go through here, we're set. Now, if I go back to this environment here, I can do the up arrow. There's a great way to rerun a command. We go into this GitHub Actions Hello World. And the beautiful thing is because I did all that hard work beforehand, I just say make all. It goes through, it runs our project, it lints our project, it tests our project. So very, very straightforward process once you've got this continuous integration set up and running for any cloud environment. And again, if I just run the Python hello file, you can see here it prints out too. Now, how would it work in other environments? Well, let's go try it out. So we can also go to Google Cloudshell, I'm sorry, to AWS Cloudshell. we can go through here and just clear off the screen here. And I'm also going to do the git clone process. So I will also go back here to this project that we had set up so I can get the GitHub Actions Hello World. And I'm going to say SSH, copy that, go to Cloudshell, do a git clone. There we go. Perfect. Again, all I need to do is create a Python virtual environment. And so we can say Python 3-m venv tilde dot venv. And then I just source it. Should take me a second. Here we go, source tilde dot venv bin activate. I cd into this GitHub Actions project. I just say make all, right? Same thing, very, very straightforward. Now let's go to Google. Let's do the same thing. Now if I go over to the Google Cloudshell environment, here we go. We can do the same thing. We can just say git, we can just, I think just paste this in. Yeah, git clone like this. Same thing, it's gonna ask for keys. We don't have the keys, not a big deal. We just do the same thing. We type in SSH keygen-t RSA. Again, copy this. We just print out the public key file, go here and cat it, print it out, put this into our GitHub account. Here we go, copy this. And if we go, let's just double check that that copied correctly. Here we go. All right, copy. Now we can go to our Cloudshell environment, which is our GitHub environment, go over to the settings, paste this in. Google Cloudshell 2022, save it. And if we go here, we can go the up arrow again, clone it, create a virtual environment. This works the same way, virtual env, tilde dot venv. We'll go ahead and source it. Source venv bin activate. Now we'll cd into that project. Do the same thing, make all. Right, identical process for every environment in the cloud and including Google Cloudshell. And it's all made possible because of the fact that we have this nice continuous integration system working with GitHub Actions. So really, this is the reason for doing continuous integration. It makes things simpler, it saves you time, and I definitely recommend you try this project out. It's at NoahGift, GitHub Actions, Hello World.